for 10K, all cause it is pen gaming. Been insane in the membrane since them days where we raved for 3 days and 4 nights and took them red eye flights. Hopped straight off the plane and threw the back door off the place. Then I stepped on stage and be like, see the crowd going ahead, they were like, so I stepped on stage and be like, ooh, yeah. Raised by some Zulu lions, taught to seek dangers, brave and defiance, boy, the Lord was doing favors, blazed through the fire, yeah, we had a few, lost a few wages, still coming rampant, misbehaving, misbehaviors, still coming anti-up, rebellion.
never feeling the pressure, please not at all. I walk in when it's crunch time, leaves in the fall. Woman on me, only hit my name on a roll call. It's like there is no ground beneath my feet, I got no flaws. Still humble, but just don't get it confused. You know who I am, there's no need to introduce. I am one of one, they can't stand it, but it's true. Sicker than the average, ain't no challenge that's immune. Baby, I'm a go-getter, go-getter. Yeah, you better go figure, go figure. Baby, I'm a go-getter, go-getter. Yeah, you better go figure, go figure.
Try and get a big stack in my bag. Where well, you know I'm getting to it, it's like that. Try and get a big stack in my bag. Yeah, you know I'm getting to it, it's like that, big stack, big stack in my bag. It's like that. Big stack, big stack in my bag.
There's a look at one of the most iconic sports venues in the lower 48, built back in 1957 under the title of City Stadium. We are at Lambeau Field in Green Bay, Wisconsin. Today, boy, what a matchup. Two NFL franchises with so much history, so much tradition, getting set to do battle here, as it'll be the Pittsburgh Steelers taking on the Green Bay Packers. On to get it started now, the kicker Chris Boswell. And off we go from Lambeau. And we will not see a run back on the opening kickoff. This will be a touchback. From UTEP, this is Aaron Jones. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Just like that, it's a gain of 12 and a first down on their first play. Well, there you go. This offense off to a strong start this afternoon.
Yeah, with a big run and a first down. That's putting what you practice into play. That's excellent execution to get things started.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Looking to throw. Bain. That's taken in by Watson. And a 5-yard gain gets him to the 42. The Packers at 4-7 now on the year. They come in losers of two straight, so trying to turn things around here.
And you just mentioned two straight, and when you're talking about two games, that's nothing to panic about. They feel like they've been a little bit unlucky in the last couple. This is a club that's more than capable of turning things around, and I expect them to play really well here.
Now a first carry for their fullback. And he will be brought down at about the 43 that time. They follow up the gain of 5 by only getting 1 there on second down.
You look at this Steeler defense.
They're a unit that enters play way down, number 28 in the NFL right now against the run.
And stopping the run, that's been an issue for them all season long. Aren't you glad that you're not coaching the defense right now?
I'm very glad. They said that they've seen it in doses, but very, very small doses.
Yeah, you've got to be consistent. It's down in and down out, being able to play it, understand what you have to get done, and finally stop some people, put them on the ground.
And he won't get to the marker. He's a yard short. A pickup of 3, it leaves him with 4th and 1. Blake Gillikin on to punt here as he'll send this one away. And just a single punt for him in the loss last week as he sends this one away.
So they'll accept that penalty, and that'll, of course, move the football up the field.
So the special teams penalty cost some yardage there as they come out on first and 10. Back to throw. Hill.
A short one there to Freiermuth.
This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and 2.
Now that's staying ahead of the chains. Really good pickup on first down, hitting the tight end there. Now it brings up a second and manageable.
Just found a hole in that zone. Two yards to go, second down. Carry for Najee Harris. And not a whole lot to speak of there as he'll bring him down shy of the 20. They got two of the three they needed there. Leaves him with third and just a yard.
Defensively, we always know that he is tough and run support. And I think the way that he gets there is he understands what an offense is going to do before the ball's even snapped. A great job of scouting prior to the game, then reading, reacting, and taking the right path to the ball carrier.
Here now, third and a yard. There's Hill. Working the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And he will have a Steelers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
A gain of 18 on the play. First down is Bird.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Play action. It's Hill. Here's one deep for Pickens. That's caught inside the 20. A big play that time for Pittsburgh. 47 yards.
When they've needed a play this year, he's certainly been the guy to deliver it. As this season has gone on, he's been awfully consistent and sometimes spectacular.
So after the big play, look at this, all the way down at the 15 now on first and 10. Harris running straight ahead. He takes us down to about the 12 for a gain of 3.
If you're looking for glory, looking to get your name in the headlines, you do not want to play nose tackle. But how about what we just saw there? The ability to hold people up, take on extra blocks, and actually slip them and make a tackle on that play. That's big time.
Counting down toward the midway point in quarter one. Harris going to get it again on second down. They'll get this down inside the 10 for a pickup in about 3.
Well, that way, picking up 3 yards a carry, you and I both know that doesn't cut it in this league and trying to get first downs, unless you're playing 4-down football. Then that's a whole different situation. But I don't think that's what they're trying to do here. 3rd and 4, though, is still manageable.
Touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Steelers have taken the early lead on the road here at Lambeau. This crew, they were on a roll going into the bye week that they just had, Charles, so sort of picking up where they left off.
And you and I both know that when you come back off of an open week and you've been winning games, you should get a few extra days off in order to recharge and refuel. But coaches often hedge their bets, too. They'll bring them back and work them really hard that first practice back to make sure that they're back and grounded.
Whatever they did, formula looking good so far in this one. And no thought to bring this one out. He'll just go down to a knee, and he'll take over at the 25.
Let's go.
About set to get this drive started. The Green Bay offense at the line. And they'll certainly be trying to do better than that first drive where they went 3 and out.
And sometimes the first drive is just simply to settle nerves. You know what it's like at the start of a game with the emotion. That's a little bit jumping. You like it's Dan the same way, just like us coming into one, right? Making sure we ease into the game, let it come to us.
Well, you went 3-0.
And have that opportunity.
No, you didn't go 3-0. I went 3-0 on that first drive. I'm trying to do better here. Here's a 2nd-and-2 now from the 33. Back to throw. Bain.
He'll drop this underneath for Jones.
And Jones going to have a Packers first down as he gets this up past the 40.
And I like the idea here. Get the ball in his hands, even if it's in the passing game. 3 catches a week ago, and he does a nice job here to pick up yardage.
Down Alexander, and good vision there as he's across midfield and down to the 45-yard line. 14 yards, good for a Packer first down.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack, because remember the last drive they went 3-and-out.
Operating out of Steeler territory now. Here's 1st and 10 at the 45-yard line. Looking to throw. Bain. That one almost intercepted, but it's incomplete. Not a good throw there, and it'll be 2nd down. You look at this Steeler defense. This crew against the pass, it's been a real struggle. 2nd from the bottom in the NFL, number 31.
And I think you're going to see some changes in the offseason, whether it's through the draft, free agency, maybe even both. They definitely need some help in the secondary.
2nd and 10, a very chilly day here, but no snow. And I got to say, if it's going to be this cold, I want snow. You should see Charles' face. He's looking at me like I'm crazy. Now left side, a completion to his tight end. And they're going to have themselves another 1st down as the tackle's made at the Steelers' 33. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs. Catch number 100 for his career right there, and it's good enough to keep the chains moving. So they'll come up 1st and 10 now from the 33. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. He hits Dobbs on the crosser. Touchdown, Packers! Romeo Dobbs, his 1st touchdown of the year. And the Packers are an extra point away from evening this one up. So a nice touchdown pass for the rookie there. And, you know, as they go down the stretch, look, they're not a playoff team. This is just confidence building and growth time for him, right?
Yeah, it's a game within the game, isn't it? Because every team wants to win all games on their schedule. But the development of this rookie quarterback is paramount for this team. So you're exactly right. Every rep, doesn't matter what the game, what the situation, what the score, valuable for him, valuable for his team as they look towards next year.
And he'll be dropped at the 21-yard line. So bringing it out of the end zone proves not a good decision. Loses him about 4 yards. The Pittsburgh offense at the line to start their next drive. And you figure this should be a healthy, arrested, a focused unit. And they're working on a good winning streak. They had the week off last week. This is really a team, Charles, that should be in top form. It's caught inside the 25. Touchdown. A big play there. 79 yards. And the Steelers have taken the lead. Seeing some pretty good offense here in this first quarter.
It's been a wild start to this quarter, as you noted. And now with that lead that we're seeing, can they retaliate? I get the sense this one's going to go back and forth all game long.
And that probably won't be the last long touchdown that we see in this one.
Chris Boswell, we kick off for Pittsburgh.
Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. And no thought to bring this one out. He'll just go down to a knee, and they'll take over at the 25. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And that last drive, so effective in the passing game, resulting in the touchdown. Maybe not many people were focused on the trenches. There was good protection there.
Excellent protection. So now, defensively, you've almost got to get down to those starters blocks like you're a sprinter. Get lower than those guys on offense and find a way to roar through them or around them to get into the face of the passer.
Easier said than done, though.
Way easier said than done. But they've got to try something, because right now, they're just cutting them to shreds.
So not quite a first down just yet as they come up on second and less than a yard. Again, it's Jones. And this will be a Packers first down as he's able to get this up past the 40.
Well, they came into this game saying it was important that they set the tone and show that they can run the football. I believe that they've done that here in the first quarter.
They'll run on first down. It's Alexander, and he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up.
This defense for the Steelers, very strong in that victory a week ago.
Yeah, what stood out to me on tape, the way they were flying to the football. So that tells me that they've got all their assignments down, and they're playing with extreme confidence.
Second down and six now. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. Give him seven on the tuck and run, and it'll give him a new set of downs.
Brandon, you know more about quarterbacks protecting themselves, but I have to admit it. I liked what I just saw there. That rookie wasn't afraid of absorbing a big hit. Now, you don't want to see him taking those shots all game long, but he picked up the first down, kept fighting for yards, and was willing to embrace some contact to keep the play moving.
Through one quarter, 14-7, our score. Back for the second quarter in Green Bay, it's the Packers in possession of the football as they've got it with a first and 10. An inside give to Jones. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
And that's exactly what offenses try to avoid by using motion and throwing different formations up. They hate when he can draw a bead on the play, get a running start, and make a big play behind the line of scrimmage as he did just there.
To throw on second down, Bain. And he finds for a set. And they're going to have themselves another first down as the tackle's made at the Steelers' 31-yard line. Give them 18 on that play, and Green Bay has the first as well.
Of course, the catch was nice, but how about what happened after? Able to stay on his feet and gain all that additional yardage. So many of these slot guys, I think, have running back in their background.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Back to throw. Bain, complete to Forsett. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
I always laugh when people say, what's the toughest route to defend? Not like any of them, especially if it's a good receiver. That makes things very difficult. But when you're running a drag route, something short, shallow, going through defenders, using guys almost as screens in order to get open, that makes things tougher, guys trying to get to the football.
On second down, it's Alexander. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. It's a gain of 12, and the Packers have the first.
For a lot of guys playing this game, there's no better feeling than running right through a tackle. He's able to lower his center of gravity and churn his legs for a really nice pickup.
Now a first and 10 at the 11. Looking to throw, Bain. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6.
They made a nice effort to stick it with a loss for that play, but it's going to take more than that to keep him from advancing the ball. Should be an entertaining battle anytime he tucks and runs over the second half of this contest.
Now second and five. Snap will come from the six.
Up the middle, Jones. And he's going to press this one forward as they stop him right around the one. After a gain of five, they'll wind up being about a length of the football short here on third down.
That was a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
They'll try and run for it with Jones. And he'll take this into the end zone for a Green Bay touchdown. Aaron Jones with his sixth rushing touchdown on the year. And the Packers are within an extra point of tying up this ball game. Carlson on for the extra point. And oh, it's blocked. This is going the other way. But he will not be able to bring this one back, and the extra point attempt unsuccessful.
I know it's easy to kind of shrug off a blocked extra point, but this game is shaping up to be a tight one. The second half, this could prove crucial.
Yeah, we might look back on this one. We'll have to wait and see.
This fielded right at the goal line. A solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32.
At their own 32-yard line.
The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive.
Well, partner, you know, coaches always say that every play is designed to score a touchdown. Sometimes that's not really true, but last drive, that was the case. One play to get into the end zone, and now they'll try to duplicate that success here.
And it's rare for those moments to happen. Incredible when they do. And you saw the celebration. Pure, unbridled joy after that one.
Ball on the 40 now. Here's second and two.
They hand this off to Harris. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line.
That one, a first down pickup of eight.
Second and two is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook. Go play action. Toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a first down. Keep the sticks moving.
Go! Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. They'll run straight ahead with Ware. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. That one good for 10 yards. And that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here.
On any explosive run, you can almost feel the ground shaking. And that's from the offensive linemen creating space for their runners. I had an old coach tell me before, they always told his runners, run around the offensive line in pregame. Get used to the ground shaking so you don't trip and fall when it happens in a game.
On second down, this is Harris. And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. A gain of five, good enough for the first down.
Second and inches is oftentimes an invitation for an offense coordinator to take a big shot downfield because he feels like he can come back on third down and pick up the first down. But sometimes you just don't want to break tendency. Stay with what you are, stay with who you know, and go get the first down. That's exactly what they did.
And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
One thing you hope to see out of a rookie tight end is a real concentration when the ball's in the air, and I'm not sure that he didn't, but he has to be prepared for people making a play on it when that ball's up for grabs.
Here's second and 10.
A give running left is where. And he'll be taken down at the 33, a pickup of about four.
That second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get him into a manageable third down because they had incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
Seventh play of the drive upcoming here on third and six. Hill looks to throw. Open target here, Darius Slayton. And he will have a Steelers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
But remember, they had the quick strike touchdown the last time they had the ball, but this time, they're having to work for it. What a nice throw there on third down, and they're able to keep the drive alive.
On first down, Hill. Throw here is incomplete.
He didn't just deny a big throw there. He broke that one up in the red zone. An excellent play, one that may help save points on the board when this drive is over.
Second and 10. Here's Hill. This is caught by Ginn. And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down. He had the touchdown earlier. This one's going to get him a first down.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against him a few minutes ago because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. A slot man in motion right. Now they fake the jet sweep there and a run instead with Harris. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and 4.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down. And as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
This is a second and 4, ball at the 9. They stay on the ground. Again, it's Harris. And the step will come inside the 5 at the 4. A 5-yard gain there makes it first and goal.
We both know it's difficult, but they've made it look effortless out there. Through the air, on the ground, they've moved the ball with relative ease.
And we've hit the 2-minute mark in this first half of action. Hill now to throw. Pickens in the end zone. Touchdown, Steelers. 4 yards on the touchdown grab. And the Steelers are able to stretch out their lead. Boswell for the extra point. And with that, the lead is up to 8.
Makes the score Steelers 21, Packers 13. Chris Boswell, the kickoff for Pittsburgh.
Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. They'll elect to bring it out here from the end zone. And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much as he's marked out officially at the 21. About set to get this drive started, the Green Bay offense at the line. So remember, Charles, last time they were out here, they scored, but they just saw the opposition score, and they're trailing right now, so they're trying to keep pace here. They need a touchdown drive.
Well, if you're a fan of offense, you're loving this, but if you're a fan of defense, this is tough to watch, and it's also tough
to keep that up when you just watch your opponent march down the field on a scoring drive that lasts into double-digit snaps. You need a score here not just to follow the momentum from your last drive, but put the onus back on your opponent. And that's what they're doing right now, swapping that onus back and forth.
From the 31, here comes second and a yard. Out of the shotgun, it's Jones. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. First down now, but the clock continues to move. Back to throw, Bain. And that'll be off the mark, too far out in front, and it's incomplete.
I know coaches tell us all the time that having a powerful arm isn't the number one thing they look for in a quarterback, but when you're trying to throw inside routes and you need to put some heat on it, it helps have the big gun. In this case, just a little bit too much.
Now it's second and 10. Looking to throw, Bain. And Jones has it over the middle. Now the Packers going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as they'll get a chance to talk it over after picking up the first down.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
So after two first downs, they get another here. First and 10 at the 45. Back to throw, Bain. Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete.
Nice progress down the field was halted by that incompletion. They could try for some safe yards here to get things moving again, or keep throwing it and pushing it downfield to try and pick up bigger yardage.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. They'll look to throw again. And his throw's going to be incomplete.
Feels like they're getting caught in between here because any incompletions on first and second down, now you got to worry a little bit about the clock because you prefer not to give them another shot here in the first half. But if you don't pick up the first down, guess what? You're likely going to have to.
Now play number 7 of the drive as they're looking at a 3rd and 10. Again, he'll drop to throw. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Alexander. So 8 yards on the completion there, and it'll be 4th down.
We can make this one pretty simple. Locked up all of his progressions downfield, forced to get it to his running back, but how about the way they ran to the football and knocked him down to force a 4th down.
The offense staying out. They're going to go on 4th and 2. Back to throw again. He's going to get that to his running back out of the backfield. And he's going to get this inside the 30. That was a pretty good job by the defense, I thought, Ryman. They had to go to their check down, but still were able to get it done for the first.
Agreed. Anytime you can force him to come back to a receiver that's a little bit shorter in the route, you've done your job on defense, but still, they pick up the first down and get a fresh set.
Huge 4th down conversion. So the drive stays alive after the 4th down conversion. First and 10 inside the 30. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw.
A short throw to Musgrave.
And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds.
Another nice gain. That's now 30 yards between those last two plays.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open. Just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space. And it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
Now a first down carry by Jones. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. Now the Packers going to burn their third and final timeout as the clock will stop with 20 seconds to go in the first half. Now a second and six.
19, Tiger. Rocco 80, 79.
Operating from the gun, Bain. This will be caught at about the six. That's a Packers touchdown. Jaden Reed, as the first half is winding down. And the Packers are able to cut into this lead in the final seconds of the first half. A little surprising they wouldn't go for two, but this is up and good. And this is now a one-point game. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. And that'll be set up with good field position here as he gets this up over the 40-yard line.
Any return to get you to midfield is a great return. One first down, you're almost in field goal position.
The Pittsburgh offense at the line to start their next drive. And with decent starting field position, they're maybe only a couple completions away from field goal range. And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
I see the surprise in your face there, partner. That is a rare incompletion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion-wise way up, not that time. Ball on the 42 as they come up second and 10. To throw is Hill. Oh, the ball comes out on the hip, but they'll say it's incomplete.
And the Packers just dropped a lot of confidence after the last one ended up as a touchdown. But incompletions on their first two throws has them huddling up and trying to figure out a big play here on third down to get their momentum going again.
Third down, here's Harris. And he gets it just shy of midfield, but that's not enough. He's short of the marker. So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports. And we welcome you back now. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon, getting set for quarter number three here. Both these offenses have been in fine form. What will the second half bring us as we are underway in quarter three? This taken in at the goal line. And he will make it to the 20-yard line. And The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. We've got a close game. The offense has played well, but right now they've got to keep their foot on the gas.
And that carries with it an extra bit of pressure, doesn't it? As much fun as they're having right now, they're locked in, really clicking on all cylinders. They also know that they ever miss a chance to put points on the board, they've actually put their team in jeopardy. And that's not how you want to play the game. It's supposed to be complementary football, offense, defense. But today, it's all offense for them.
Yeah, they've been playing with a sense of urgency. It's probably going to need to continue. On the give, this is Harris. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. 68 yards on the ground for him now on 9 carries.
Most of their damage has been done through the air. I mean, they've run the bell 3 times with passing touchdowns, but guess what? Ground game has not been neglected. Nice little burst right there.
On the give, this is their fullback. A tackle that time by Jonathan Ford.
Well, big man with bar. Bigger man on the other side of the line. A really nice play for the defense.
Second down and 8. They'll try the air now with Hill. He gets it complete to Harris. And this is going to result in another first down as the tackle's made at the Packers' 32-yard line. 12 yards that time and a Pittsburgh first. Whatever the discussions were at halftime to try to slow down this offense, it has not worked to this point.
Yeah, I have a vision right now of everything that was discussed at the half just being torn in shreds or being erased off of the Microsoft Surface tablets because none of it is working. They are really locked in on offense.
Now Hill looking to throw on first. He's got this to Pickens. And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. 2 catches in the first half. Now he's got a 3rd here, and it's good for a first.
I'll tell you what, a lot of those mid-range throws have been available because sometimes teams get too concerned about the deep ball and they leave too much space in front of them. And these guys have been taking advantage so far.
Here's a 1st and 10 at the 14-yard line. Hill now operating from the red zone. Finding Pickens for another catch. So the completion good for 6 yards. And that's going to bring up 2nd down.
It's a game of matchups, and that's why you take your receivers and move them around a bunch, especially your best guys. And when they work out of the slot, you often hear the coaches talk about how great it is because it gives you a 2-way go. You can break out or you can break in. That makes it hard to defend.
A run with Harris out of the shotgun. And he's going to take it in for a Steeler touchdown. Najee Harris, a 9-yard touchdown run. And the Steelers take the opening kickoff of the 3rd quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead. Boswell good with the extra point. And the lead is up to 8.
Steelers 28, Packers 20.
Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. And we'll see a return here from the end zone. And he'll be out of bounds here just past the 20-yard line. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. They'll start the drive with a carry by Jones. He'll get a nice chunk there on the 1st down run, and it's 2nd and 4.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here, and if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of 1st downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up a score.
Ball on the 28-yard line. Here's a 2nd down and 4. Looking to throw. Bain over the middle, complete. It's Reed. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. He had the touchdown earlier. This one's going to get him a first down.
And that's a more than acceptable read right there because it's zone coverage. So timing is everything. This time he waits for his man to come open, puts it right on him, and they pick up a first down.
The give is to Jones, and he takes it past the 45 and down at the 46. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
Oh, that was a thing of beauty right there. Look at how quick those blockers fired off the line once the ball was snapped. That was an O-line on a mission, all in sync, and the defense is lucky that play only picked up 5 yards.
Looking to throw on second down. Bain, he finds his man, complete. It's Pearson. And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
Good, sure hands there from a guy not accustomed to catching a whole lot of passes. But how about the way he was able to pull that one in and pick up good yardage?
Operating out of Steeler territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 46. A give to Jones. He takes this for about 6 down inside the 40.
Offensive linemen love creating space for their guys carrying the ball. But when that guy also breaks tackles and creates extra yardage, they almost feel like he's one of them, and they really embrace him.
Ball on the 39. Here's second and 4. Up the middle they go. Alexander, and they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
Well, you know they had a third down play on standby just in case, but he says no need with that carry. Runs like that will continually earn him more work in this and future contests.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Laundry on the field. This is going to be a false start on the offense.
Sometimes you have to slow things down a little bit when things get heated. The cadence has to be slow and deliberate at times to make sure your team's ready to go.
The false start backs him up 5, first and 15. Back to throw. Bain. A short throw to Musgrave. Without the previous penalty, that would have been a first down. Instead, it's just a gain of 10.
Well, that's always a good place to throw it just because he's one of the biggest targets not only on this team but in the National Football League.
And you and I both know the quarterbacks love these large body tight ends, and why not? Nowadays, they're really wide receivers who are just taller and have a little bit more weight. These guys catch the football, make big plays downfield. In the old days, we wanted them to block. Now coaches want them to catch the football first.
And he will slide down with the first down for the moment, but a penalty flag on the field. So they elect to decline it.
And why not? Just go ahead and let the play stand, and they'll take that.
Let's go now.
After the penalty, it's Jones. And they'll lose yardage here. Knocked back to the 19-yard line. It's a loss of 4 there, bringing up second down.
That seemed to be linebacking 101 on how to diagnose and stop a run.
And what we're doing nowadays is we're taking those former safeties, those bigger guys, and making them linebackers to utilize their speed. He just made an absolute beeline after he diagnosed that play and ended up making a nice tackle on it.
To throw on second down. Bain, he gets that one complete to Wicks. Call that a gain of 5 as the clock ticks inside of 2 minutes to go now in the third.
They kept the receiver in the short field, but that let his quarterback get the ball quickly to him before either guy in double coverage could react.
Oh.
They'll come to the line here needing 9 yards to pick up the first.
On third down, Bain. He finds his man complete. That's Reed. And he'll get inside the 10, but he's short of the line he needed. So 5 yards here, 5 on the play. And that's going to make it fourth down.
Anders Carlson on for the field goal.
And his kick is right there. It's good. And that'll get the lead down to 5. So the response to that touchdown on the other side to begin the third quarter. Look, just 3 points, but still a response nonetheless.
You're exactly right about that, because I think you needed to answer back with something, even though it's not 6. Just enough to send the message that says, hey, we're not going away.
Austin elects to bring this out of the end zone. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line.
The Pittsburgh offense at the line to start their next drive.
Well, certainly they'd rather have the scenario they had last time. Now, Charles, remember, they had the short field. They took it in the end zone. Now this is going to have to be a longer, more sustained drive if they want to get points.
Yeah, a little bit more of a quick strike opportunity last time by where they were on the field, and you're exactly right about that. But now, backed up a little bit. What's that old expression we love to use? Time to matriculate the ball down the field and try and do it again.
They like going to him in the slot. He catches another one.
I think this comes under the heading of, until they stop him, why not go back to it? He has something going really well. Great working relationship with the guy throwing the ball, and they keep making the connection.
And this is going to be a Steelers first down as the tackle made just shy of the 30.
Not too many more ideal situations at 2nd and 2 in order to try and pick up a first down. They ran it and picked it up.
Here we go, catch! Hustle, hustle!
And as they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. On 1st and 10, Hill. One incomplete. The pressure got to him as he released it, and it's 2nd down.
I think he's as fine with that incompletion as a quarterback can be, in all honesty. He avoided his first sack of the game, and he did have a chance of connecting for yardage, just unable to on that throw.
Here's 2nd and 10 now from the 29. Here's Hill. This one to Slayton over the middle. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. 2nd catch for him today, and it'll wind up a 1st down.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice 1st down. Drive keeps moving.
On 1st down, it's Hill. And his throw is incomplete.
Well, they've been back on their heels a little bit here on this drive, but a chance to exhale just a little bit there with incompletion on 1st down. Now they have to gear up, try and get 2 more stops, and escape this drive.
After the incomplete pass, here now is 2nd and 10. Off of play action, Hill. That ball caught by Slayton. And this is going to result in another 1st down as the tackle's made at the Packers' 32-yard line. A good pickup there, a 22.
And these guys certainly are not hiding what their intention is. They're absolutely showing it. They're definitely not going to sit on this lead here in the 4th quarter.
Now a 1st down carry for Harris. And he's able to work his way down inside the red zone to the 19-yard line. 90 yards rushing for him now as he has been tremendous all day long.
I think there's a fatigue factor that's kicking in defensively. You know the will is still strong, but I think the offense is starting to bend it just a little bit, don't you?
Yeah, absolutely. It's looked that way. We'll see if they can continue this already strong drive.
Running on first down with Ware. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well.
As I take a look at the clock, I realize that this drive is eating up a good portion of the fourth quarter already. Got to tell you, partner, when you're trying to salt away a game, this is exactly what it's supposed to look like.
So first and goal, 6 points here would go a long way toward wrapping this one up. Back to throw, Hill. Zone. Touchdown, Steelers. Darius Slayton from 8 yards out. And the Steelers add on to their lead, and they are also closing in on a fifth straight victory. Extra point put through by Boswell, and it gives his guys a 12-point advantage. Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. And it'll come out to the 25 as he will not attempt to return. About set to get this drive started, the Green Bay offense at the line. And you figure after giving up that last touchdown, you know, they trail by 2 scores here in the fourth quarter. This drive becomes very critical. And they're able to get this one across the 35. The drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup. Fourth quarter, every drive so critical. And you figure may only get one more shot after this, so a touchdown's imperative on this drive.
It is, but you also have to think to yourself in play calling, don't hold anything back. Don't save it for the second touchdown. You got the first one for the second one to even matter.
Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete.
Oh, this defense knows. Fourth quarter, they need to make a play. That one was ripe for the taking. Could have changed the complexion of the ball game, but it winds up incomplete.
They'll try again from the 36 on second and 10. To throw again, Bain. And he finds Forsett. And they bring him to the ground just shy of midfield. 13 yards, first down Packers.
Good yardage on the completion there. When they look at the scoreboard, they do understand a field goal is not going to do them any good. My guess, they're going to press the ball downfield as far as possible, try and throw it into the end zone and get a score because they know they've got to get that done and get the ball back as quickly as possible.
Throwing on first down, Bain. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2.
I do think it's fair to say that they were caught off guard a little bit when he decided not to throw it on first down. But give them credit, they recovered in time to deny him the first down yardage. But it's only second and short, so that run is still likely to lead to a new set of downs.
Looking to throw on second down. Bain. Now a quick throw there, but it's going to be incomplete. Not sure what happened out there, but it looked like the timing was a little off on that throw.
Well, you know I'm a defender, so what am I going to say?
Great defense.
And darn right. They did something to disrupt that timing.
And this offense on third down today, they've only converted once in 4 tries. Here it's 3rd and 2. Looking to throw. Bain working the middle of the force and hit. He lost the football. And it's picked up by the Steelers. And his guys are going to get the football at the 28-yard line.
A lot of talk this week about ball security. In fact, they added an extra period in practice to be more secure with the ball. It didn't work out there.
Well, sometimes you just get overexcited during the game. You may all of a sudden make your catch, see some open field, and decide you're going for it, and not realizing the danger lurks while you're doing so. And there's your end result right there.
103 yards rushing on 12 carries for him now. And carries like that, that's how they're going to continue to salt this thing away here, Charles, in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, how about that? A new set of downs. Clock continues to move. No better way to close out a game than to tap those mastodons you have up front and say, guys, keep pounding them. Let's keep the ball, keep their offense on the sidelines, and let's close this one out.
It's a six-yard pickup, and it gets them to second and four. If you can keep getting gains like that, Charles, with the lead here in the fourth quarter, I mean, keep running it, right?
No doubt about it, but what the offense coordinator has to do is understand they're going to continue to stack the line of scrimmage. What runs do you have in your arsenal that'll work against a stacked box and continue to move the ball?
Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll leave them with a third and three.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
A short one there to Freiermuth. And he will have a Steelers first down. It won't be by much. He needed three, and he got three, barely. But the mark shows first down. And looking to put this game on ice in the fourth quarter, but still not afraid to throw it, as they show there.
You want to play the game with confidence, and they have a guy who's in control right now. Their trigger guy throwing it, they feel just as confident with him doing that as they would if they tried to run the ball and run the clock out.
And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere.
Brought down that time by Quay Walker.
He's having a big game running the football, but that one will hurt the yards per carry a little bit.
Yeah, but the average he's got so far, that's the type of average he wants to take with him to contract negotiations, doesn't he?
Here's Hill. That swung out wide to Harris. And this is going to result in another first down as the tackle's made at the Packers' 38-yard line. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Harris running straight ahead. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Tackle made by Devondre Campbell. That time they're able to bottle him up, but he's having a really nice game.
I agree with that. Let's just go big picture, right? Every back that's in the Hall of Fame had carries where they didn't gain yardage or they lost yardage, but you stick with them, don't you? When they're having a good game, keep feeding them.
Fighting his way down to about the 35-yard line. It's a gain of about three, but it's going to leave them with third and still 7 yards to go.
Like any team, they would have loved to have had more yards on that run, but it looks like they just want to get to the two-minute warning and see what they want to do after that.
2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. Now this is a big third down, and you'd have to think we'd see a timeout right away if they can't stop them here. Try to take this home. They'll run. And a good job defensively. They stop him short of the first at the 32. And now we'll see a timeout used on defense as they stop it right out of the break with 1:57 to go in the ballgame. Now Chris Boswell for the Steelers field goal try. This will be from 49 yards out. Boswell's kick is good. So after 5 touchdowns offensively, hey, maybe it's time to get the kicker a little work, and he's able to connect there.
I love that empathetic side of you. You're worried about him getting some action, getting to be a part of the game. Well, he got in and got it done.
And not willing to risk another fumble, he'll sit on this one. It's a touchback. They'll come up first and 10 here. Throwing to start the drive. Bain. Watson making the catch. Taking it right down Broadway. Christian Watson. Touchdown, Packers. Christian Watson. 75 yards. And the Packers are able to make some inroads here to that deficit.
Okay, so they got the score. Do you go for one here and save the possible two-point conversion for later?
I think you do, because if you go for two here and you don't get it, that's deflation.
Yeah.
Now you wonder why you're even going for it. Take the easy one now and come back and try and get it later.
And now in a nine-point game, they'll still just need to go for one here. As this gets them back within a touchdown and a two-point conversion. So here we go. They'll need the recovery, obviously, then a touchdown and a two-point conversion to tie. And this doesn't work. The Steelers recover it. And now looking at the clock here, they do have two timeouts, but even if they force a three and out, they're going to have very little time remaining.
So that means they've got to be aggressive and find a way to knock the ball free. They've got to come up with it, because they can't just rely, as you noted, on using their timeouts and getting the ball back. They might not have any time to mount an attack, even if they do play it that way. Get the football. That's their mantra.
Looks like he's going to get a couple here on this first down carry, and that'll make it second and eight. Now a second timeout called for by the defense as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. This, in all probability, another run here on second and eight. They hand this off to Harris. And he'll go down here at the 35-yard line. Now the Packers going to burn their third and final timeout as they'll get it with just over 90 seconds to go in the ballgame. They'll come up facing third and five. Short one there to Freiermuth. And he is going to have a Steeler first down. All smiles on that sideline. That should be the one to do it.
He's been the go-to guy. They needed a big play there on third down. Went his way. It worked out.
Doesn't matter whether they've scouted it or that they think he's going to get the ball. He has a knack for finding his way open and completing the connection.
And they'll take a knee as the clock ticks down toward 50 seconds to go. So he'll take a knee here to wrap this one up, and he's going to want to keep that game ball. He was sensational. So this one in the win column for the Pittsburgh Steelers, and never an easy thing to do, no matter how good Green Bay is, what the year is, to come into Lambeau and get the victory, but they did it.
You're not just battling the team that you're playing that day. You're not just battling the crowd that's in attendance in that game. You're battling the history of the franchise. You're battling the ghosts that swirl around that place that help spur them on to...
Jack in my side, you gotta come and check in. If the wind get hectic, don't make me slide up on you, no electric.